science of aloha. You know, I want to ask a question. And so imagine, yeah, there's a natural disaster is happening. And actually, it's a very good example in a big island. You know, literally, the lava is coming. It's coming to your door, going to take away your home. What are you going to do? So some of you say, I'm going to, yeah, so think about what you're going to do. So when I, so the one beloved one, Suri said it's going to flee. Yeah, so I, you know, happened, you know, moved to Hawaii. I was very fortunate. And to be able to move to Hawaii, this on a big island called Hawaii Island, about more than 20 years ago. About 20 years ago, I think, yeah. About 20 years ago. And maybe less than 20 years ago. And so it was, our neighborhood is basically very active with lava. So what you are going to do when you, you know, this, I literally heard so many stories, you know, like and the lava is coming to the door and take over the whole neighborhood. And I heard many people, they telling me about their homes and being taken away. So what do you do in those situations? And especially at this moment, right now, you know, humanity, Mother Earth is inflicted with so many kinds of natural disasters. Fire, water, war, earthquake, you know, mudslide, storm, you name it. So in my neighborhood, one of the, my favorite place I go to is we have this this local bar, and it's actually right at the where people go to visit lava. And this is Uncle Billy's home. And so, and they like to tell me their story. Actually, many of my friends, they tell me about their volcano stories. When volcano come, you know, the, you know, life lavas come, going to take away your home. What's the Hawaiians do? The Hawaiians, they tell me they actually, they'll clean up their home and they will prepare a meal. And they also bring a hard liquor and prepare their meal and the hard liquor and put at the door and offer to the Pele. So for them, so Pele, you know, they bring this natural disaster, but for them, this is a very special guest. They're going to come to their home. So they prepare, they clean up their home just as if they are going to receive the most respected guest. They prepare their home, clean up their home, prepare a nice meal, and also wine, prepare the wine and the liquor and offer. Of course, they will also pray, you know. So Uncle Billy's home, it was actually, you know, this is what happened to Kalapana. The whole neighborhood was mostly taken away. There's a beautiful queen's bath and the king's bath and a beautiful pond, hot spring pond. It was all taken away by some of the most beautiful scenery on a big on the big island, Hawaii, was taken away by the lava. So this is what Uncle Billy told me. This is what his wife did. His wife prepared the meal and also offered the meal, and last moment left home. And the lava stopped right before it reached their home. At this moment, their home become, they actually opened up a market, and their home, they opened a market, and so they have night market and a daytime market, and also it's become like a tourist scenery, you know, tourists will stop there and become a gathering place for our neighborhood. So I was very lucky when about, less than 20 years ago, when I was, I felt in my physics, I felt in my memory, marriage, and I moved to Hawaii. And it is, but I was very lucky, and I moved to this part of the Hawaii, which has a lot of native Hawaiians live. And the Hawaiian farmers and the families are very active. And I was happened to open up a factory, and a lot of working with a lot with Hawaiian herbs and also Hawaiian farmers. So I heard a lot of stories like this. And I really started to make friends with them and listen to their stories and working with them. And their aloha spirit completely changed my life. It is when I come to Hawaii, I suddenly realize, oh my God, you know, even all my life, I have many people, they like me, they love me. And when I went to Hawaii, I suddenly realized I have never fell in love. In fact, I feel I really not really lived. It's in Hawaii when I started to learn about the spirit of aloha. I suddenly starting to feel what it really means to be alive. What it really means, what really the paradise means. You know, before I moved to Hawaii, I know this word paradise, but I don't know what that means. Not even, and even less, how this means to live in paradise. Imagine you are in paradise. What is, do you know actually how to live there? And for me, actually, I was gradually learn how to live in paradise. And gradually learn what does it mean. What is a paradise and how to live in a paradise? Because if we don't know how to live, what do we mean how to live in a paradise? We are in paradise, we're not really living it. Do you know how to live in paradise? What does it mean to be living in the paradise? And that's what I have learned, the gift to move to Hawaii, the gift Hawaii have taught me. What is paradise? What does it mean to live in paradise? What is aloha? what it's like to live in the Aloha. And to learn, to really have this deep experience about Aloha and about paradise and living in paradise. And to me, that is one of the biggest awakening in my whole life. That is the foundation for me to really be able to get into the spiritual journey and also progress in my spiritual journey. And to me, without that, any spiritual, anything is, to achieve anything is difficult in life. But if you really understand Aloha and how to live in paradise, life becomes so easy. Life can become pure bliss, pure love, pure joy, and pure abundance. Every moment. So I realized this, you know, I was very grateful Yanan and Hardeep, you know, they actually chose this title for this workshop. I was so excited when they brought this up, because this is what really I realized so important for everyone. You know, my experience is not just my experience. I think it is a lesson for everyone. To be able to learn about Aloha. So what is Aloha? So that's come to Hawaii, and I remember the Aloha. I'm learning the Aloha when, you know, I was talking to a kahuna. He came to my home talking about how to use a leaf, you know, noni leaf, to wrap up my feet and wrap up my skin to have a beautiful noni leaf nourishment. Or walking around the jungles to pick up the fruit, papayas, mangoes, durians, you know, and I do the yoga on the beach, swim with dolphins, to really be with the air, and I just love the Hawaiian air. The air is so soft. Just the air itself feels so much love. And every breath, Aloha, you know, I is connect with your heart. You know, some people said Hawaii is the heart of Mother Earth. The I is really connect with the heart. The ah, the sound in ah, is to open our heart. So that's together. Like it puts our hand in our, on our heart. Let's chant together. To the lower abdomen, expand the lower abdomen, exhale, and then we ah. Inhale, exhale. Ah. Inhale, exhale. Ah. Inhale, exhale. So aloha first, the aloha first is open our heart to breathing life, the life in the air, in the trees, in the fruit, in the sand, on the ground. I remember in Hawaii, I just love to walk barefoot everywhere. I only put on the shoes I have to go to the city. You know, I live in a very rural area. I hardly go to the city. Sometimes I go to the city, I put on the, sandal. Mostly I'm just bare feet everywhere, going everywhere. Because just the land, you won't just feel the land. Hawaii land is just so powerful. But everywhere is. So use our heart to live, to feel everything. To feel the waves, feel the sky, the stars, galaxies, the ocean. At hot springs. We have a lot of hot spring in our neighborhood. So lucky. I almost go to hot spring every day. Sometimes a few times a day. It's right to my house, so it's not so difficult. So open your heart to feel everything. You know, even the lava coming over, gonna burn your house. The Hawaiians open their heart with love. That's how they treat life. That is aloha. So when I really learned, you know, learning about aloha, I suddenly realized, oh my God, I have not really lived before that. I did not really live. It's almost like my life was wasted. Just open the heart to embrace everything and connect with everything at a deep level. You know, my neighbors, they will, you know, teach me how to, even you plant a tree or cut off a tree, you ask permission. Even take a pet pebble from the beach, you ask permission. And they would teach me everything has a profound impact on you. And one of the kahuna, and he was telling me about, he picked up a pebble from the beach, and he, you know, somehow he put the beach just by his bed, and he said in that time he was still young, and he tried to have a girlfriend, but for a long time he just cannot have a girlfriend. And later the elders, you know, he's been trained as a kahuna, So elders find out, he said, you know, that that Pepo was jealous of him to have a girlfriend. And that's why he cannot have a girlfriend. And so he said he, later he respectfully bring the pebble back to the beach and put it back to the ocean. So after that, very quickly, he was able to have a girlfriend. Yeah, I just heard so many stories. I learned so much. And one of my biggest thing I learned, and one of the very dramatic moment I had is actually one of my girlfriend, she's a kahuna, she held ceremony on the crater. You know, crater is the, it's this, you know, the place the volcano shoot up, you know, and then flow out, the lava flow out. So it's a big hole. And so when they had a ceremony, so there, the hole is very, very big, and under it there's still some eruptions. So we had a ceremony, you know, on top of it. And so she and her husband, and they had, both of them are kahuna, they lead a ceremony. And to guided us to meet with volcano goddess. And and to connect with her. And I remember, and it was such a beautiful experience. I connected with her, and she appeared as a very beautiful woman, and she called me sister, and she showed me her power. She showed me her creation power and how she creates, you know, creates the earth. And she told me, you have this power as well. She said, trust yourself, use your heart. Don't be afraid of it. So when you can connect with your heart, you can create miraculously and powerfully. Have a strong impact. And life can really become alive, you know? And I realized all my life before that, I was not even alive. You know, before I went to Hawaii, and I'm not fully alive. Still very much in the head, you know, the heart, we have not truly experienced life. So high is really have this hard power and the force and to moves through, and the low, you know, our low is like connect. So this is what Hawaii really teached me, to connect with the source. In fact, you know, in one of the ceremonies I went to in Hawaii, I was, a divine actually come to me. And it showed me how much, you know, it was actually the ceremony. There's so many people dancing and singing. And I was just sitting there. I went with friend, but I would just feel like sitting there, and I was just feeling it. And and then I just feel like the air just filled with love. And then I feel like everything just become love. Yeah. Everything is just love, and it was loving me. And this whole air is filled with love and loving me. You know, the sound is loving me, every singing and dancing loving me. And then very soon I feel this divine presence, which is include everyone, everything, and bigger than anyone, you know, everything I can imagine. You know, its presence beyond my comprehension, and it's loving me. I was like, wow. And I was crying. I was so touched by that love. I was so overwhelmed by that love. I started to cry. And for the first time in my life, I was able to connect with the source, the divine, and feel the divine's love. So connect is the key. Can we connect with the land? Connect with the Pele, the volcano god? Can we connect with the water, the waves? Can we connect with our own heart and connect with the divine? So when I was able to connect with all this, I was suddenly become alive. I suddenly know what is really love. When I really know what is really love, then the rest life, it just becomes so easy, effortless. You know, that is when I started to really have experiencing prosperity. You know, my business doing extremely well, you know, and I think of something, things just happen, and you know, I have great friends and family. It just, everything just beautiful. And I truly, you know, every day I starting to have deeper understanding what it means to live in paradise. Living in the paradise is really means that we can open our heart to connect with everything in love. Feel everything is loving us. Divine and the source is loving us. And we can connect with the life force that is within us, in everyone, everything. And we can truly live and become alive. So humanity, and also myself before, was so much in the, you know, in the mind. You know, I'm not really actually, you know, when I went to Hawaii, I realized I have not really lived. I have not really lived. I have not really lived a life, experienced life. So this is so important for all of us to learn. So I'm so grateful to Hawaii, really teach me, and the Hawaiians, they teach me how to live. A big part of my life, and it was missing before. Many people. And so when I was able to live like that, you know, everything else just come. And that is what it actually is supposed to be. And it's in Hawaii, I started, you know, the Tao science. So when I was really be able to open up and learn, that is when I was, you know, my spiritual channel started to open, and I starting to pay attention and really want to to develop my spiritual journey, and then met Master Shah. And then later, you know, we wrote two books and also founded the Tao Science. So Tao Science is a science. Tao Science is created in Hawaii. And most important discovery is made and also written, a big part of the book is written in Hawaii. So that is why it's so exciting for me to teach this workshop, especially with Malia. And Malia is, you know, she's a native Hawaiian, and she's going to teach us about this creation chant. I cannot even say the name, I apologize for it. And I read it before, but I did not truly, you know, deeply understand it too much. So I'm really looking forward to learn it from her before, with her. So this chant is 2,000 phrases. And Hawaiian, they have their beautiful chant, how everything's created. It's very profound and very profound. And from little I know, I don't want to share too much, but from little I know, it is very, very profound. So I'm so looking forward to learn that. You know, Hawaiians, you know, it's some of people even told me that in the chant, they even acknowledge they coming from the stars, you know, from galaxies and other galaxies, and coming here, how everything is created. So, and all of that wisdom, you know, and these has, you know, many different, you know, and it's, you know, it's can be explained, and you know, also understood with Tao Science. And so I'm very looking forward to learn more deeply from Malia. And she's just, you know, she's the person I really love. And I remember the first time I met her is in actually on the Big Island. At that time, Master Shah also come to the Big Island. We had a workshop. And so we had a small group did at So Song So Dance or something, an evening and a concert or something in my neighborhood. And Malia is sitting behind me and she was giggling. That's how I met her first time. And so I'm so looking forward to have this workshop with her and to learn her wisdoms, and also share about the Tao Science, how the Tao Science can, you know, can help us actually go deeper into this aloha and truly understand the aloha at deep, you know, at a deeper level. And also we're going to use some Tao Science techniques to help us to go deeper to the aloha. So Tao Science, you know, it is brings the quantum physics and also grand unification theory, which is basically the holy grail in physics right now. And it combines this with spiritual wisdom, you know, of Tao. The Tao is a source. It's also a very profound, deep wisdom about the source. So Tao Science is a science of creation, a science of the source, a science of grand unification, science of oneness. So it can help empower each one of us and go to a higher level. So it's not a coincidence. Tao Science is coming from Hawaii. And also, you know, I was forced to live Hawaii. Not really forced, I can still go back, but right at this moment, maybe life has caused me for going everywhere and to spread aloha. So everywhere I go, I love to talk about Hawaii. Because this Aloha spirit is so important for humanity at this moment. This Aloha spirit of Hawaiian is so important for all of us to learn and to go deeper to learn. So I'm very grateful to teach this because this has given me an opportunity to go back further and spread this. And when you really learned the aloha, you can benefit the rest of your life. Everywhere you go, people are going to join to you. They know you are different. They know you know something they don't know. They want to know. They want to learn from you. And they want to be with you. That's what I experienced. When I really truly learned, even as a Hawaiian, when I learned the aloha, and everywhere I go in the world, people are just drawn to you. There's something about you they want to learn. So no matter what difficulties, challenges in your life, whether you want to become more successful in business, or have better relationships, or have profound spiritual, growth, or to create something, art, or a home, or business. Or become very intelligent, or even doing science. My best science is actually done in Hawaii. It's now making me feel like I need to go to Hawaii again. Have so many friends who in Hawaii, they all want me to go visit them. But every time I go to Hawaii, actually, I just live on the beach. I love to live on the beach. And it's just so beautiful. So no matter what you do, the Aloha Spirit is going to help you. And all of us can go deeper into this Aloha Spirit. So one of the things actually I love about Hawaii. In Hawaii, one of my favorite thing is to do is I walk around. If I'm like the mealtime walk around, and there's always people to feed me. And people literally like we in my home we have a lot of parks. In the park, a lot of people they will hang out there or doing barbecue. And a lot of people they just bring a lot of food and do barbecue, and everybody come. They just feed everyone. And so oftentimes I like that's what I like to do, walk around to get other people's food and talk with them. And or sometimes just walk around with friends, pick up fruit to eat. And a lot of my friends they like to go to the water, get a fish, and then barbecue on the by the in the park, and then give to everyone. But oftentimes it is sometimes it's like the whole day can be easily gone. I remember when once sometimes like in the morning I go to have a go to the hot spring pond, and then my friend was have a barbecue in the fish, right? So I would go in there eating fish, and then somebody offered a massage. I'd be get a massage on the beach. And then somebody was dancing and singing and playing the ukulele. So very easily the whole day is gone. But that was just so beautiful. You know, I actually the most productive in that kind of environment in my science. And really learn how to truly enjoy life as well. And to every moment to live in love, in aloha, to each other and to other people. This is something I have to learn. You know, I remember when I first got to Hawaii, I don't do that. You know, I was thinking about work and work, work. It's actually not as effective. When I truly learned how to enjoy life every moment. And that is when actually the true prosperity and true creation in creativity, invention, abundance, bliss come. And many things in that aloha spirit, we could make things happen so easily and so quickly. I truly believe in the future, life should be effortless. That is also the Tao. So one of my Hawaiian friends, they have a big family. Yeah, some of my Hawaiian friends, their family have thousands of people. If they have a gathering, they have thousands of people gathering. That is how big they are. They even have their own like tournament, and they only have their own church, their family church. That is how big their family is. And one of my friends, they said the, you know, this is another family. This family, they said they actually, you know, they will open up a place outside, cooking the omelets and other fishes and stuff, and just cook everything, and then everybody come and they can, you can just eat it. And they do that every Sunday and feed everyone. Anybody, you can go there and just eat their food. That it was just like a natural, it's like a natural thing happened. So I'm going to, you know, in this workshop really teach you why we should live like this. This is a new era we need to live in. Why we have to be always stressed and fighting with each other, and how to think about protecting ourselves, making enough money and doing this and doing that. There is enough food everywhere. There's enough place to live for everyone. And to build one is not that difficult. It is our own consciousness need to change. We, our humanity has stayed in this lacking, this this mentality of lacking and struggle. Literally the rest of the world like live in this kind of thing. You know, in China, that's how we brought up. You know? But the Hawaiian tradition is different. For them, they don't have this concept of yours and mine. It's like we share. And this kind of, and when we can live out of this, and things can be so easy and so everything will become easier. Literally, like I remember, you know, once I was, so in Hawaii, what I really learned is actually learned not working. And literally like my business became more and more successful without working. and the science too. My science will be better without me working, because you have to let go of this struggle mentality. That struggle mentality stay with you, you're going to ruin your life, because your whole life you're going to keep struggling. You have to let that go. The Tao, the source, is not struggle. The Tao and source is emptiness. Let's take it easy. When you can really live like that, and the true prosperity then comes. And I remember actually in Hawaii, when I truly learned this, actually I stopped working hard. I stopped even work to go to work. But then that's actually the, you know, like, I think of something, things will happen. I remember once I thought of, actually it was just in the morning, I sit by them, you know, sit at my home, lanai, and which is facing the ocean. The idea comes about starting a company, actually a network marketing company. It was like the thought in the come in. And then my friend called from New York. And I just, I know he called, I just shared. I said, I want to start the company. How about you help me? You know, and he come to Hawaii. He was sitting, come in, he and a girlfriend would stay with me. I said, how about you help me? So, and I said that, I forgot about it. And the next day, and he got like some famous people or some people like called me, and they said they are in a network marketing company, and they were told they come to help me. So my friend, got them to help me. And in the 3 months, we opened up, I opened up a network company, and with all these people helping. And without me doing anything, the company just growing. So it's really just, we have to open our heart to be in that state, allow this creation to run through us. The creator wants to create things, and we have to be in this state of aloha, allow this effortless creation to go through us. And this is a state, it can be achieved. And I think everybody should learn this, literally everyone. This is something, the best thing I have ever learned. This is literally the best thing I have ever learned. And I hope the whole humanity can learn this. We do not have to struggle. We can bring paradise to Mother Earth. We all can love each other, support each other, share things with each other, and live in paradise. Learn how to live in paradise. I literally think, before, I don't know how to live in a paradise. I'm thinking about struggle, and my whole life is struggle. When I learn how to live in the aloha, I live in the paradise, and paradise come to me. So everybody need to learn this. Everyone. Why you want to struggle? Why? We don't have to. Of course, our parents tell us we have to. And society maybe also tell us we have to. But those are all nonsense. They don't know better. Do they really know better? Do they have a better life? No. And we can create a better life. We can create a better humanity and better Mother Earth. And we can do it. But we have to learn. We have to learn, and it's learning the spirit of aloha and how to live in aloha is so important for everyone. It's so important for everyone. So I want to end this today's session with blessing to everyone, and for us to all open our hearts to live in aloha. I think we all deserve this, humanity deserves this, and working together, we can bring paradise to Mother Earth and to our lives. We can learn how to live in paradise. We, no matter where you live, we can bring paradise to our lives. It's really just how you live and how, and what's your consciousness way to live. Yes. So let's close our eyes. And maybe how about together we sing aloha together? Aloha. 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 Let's close the eyes. And I breathe in this beautiful air in aloha air in Hawaii. Feel the jumping of the dolphins in such a joy. Beautiful sun, the moon, and our feet is on the beautiful sand in Hawaii. The ocean, the waves comes splash on our feet. Feel this beautiful spirit. So open our heart to embrace all the elements and go deep ourselves to open our heart to the aloha, to connect the life force of the heaven, earth, the source, and with everything in the sand, in the water, in the air, in the palm trees, coconut trees, in the stone, in the smile. And I feel all these beautiful elements is within us. The source is within us, Mother Earth is within us. And we are one with all of this. And I open our every cell organs to embrace life. To embrace everyone, everything that is within us and in everyone, everything. With love, with joy, with honor and respect. Let's open our heart to the aloha. Let's open our heart to the paradise. Know that we can bring the paradise to our lives, to humanity and to Mother Earth. Together we can do that. And we start with to learn and truly learn this. And together we can do it. So I'm so looking forward to tomorrow. We have another introduction at the with actually Mas Malia, and also tomorrow and this, on this weekend. I'm so looking forward to it. I cannot wait for us to all go deeper into this Aloha spirit. So in before the white people come in Hawaii, they have on the big island, they have millions of people live on the big island. And now there's only about 100,000 people live there, and still they don't have enough, most food is carried from somewhere else. So we can really see this spirit of aloha can really create amazing abundance. You know, also Hawaiians, they live in amazing joy, and in the old times, they actually spent a few months not working, just really having fun, you know? It's so important for all of us. We need to have fun. We need just to have joy and to really just live. It is in life. All the creations, all the growth, magic happens. Yeah. So I'm so looking forward to being in this workshop with all of you and to embrace this magic that is within all of us. And I'm so looking forward to it. So I welcome you to join me, this and Malia, and this other master teachers with me this weekend. And also tell your friends and family and join us. Yeah, you know, if you have any difficulties, let me know. We'll be able to help you with the spirit of aloha. Let's help each other. And that's together bring the aloha and bring the paradise to Mother Earth. I'm so looking forward to it. Thank you so much. Love you all. Thank you so much. And I give it back to you, Yanan. And also Hardeep.
Thank you so much, Rulin. This is Hardeep. In case anyone hasn't met me, I'm also one of the master teachers here in Hawaii. I've been captivated for the last 1 hour. The moment Dr. Rulin started speaking, I was just captivated. I live in Hawaii, but to hear her side of it, to hear her story and experience of it was something else. I just was hanging on to every word and every fond memory that she shared with us, but also the deep wisdom. And this blessing that she just gave us, this practice she led us through, you know, even though I live here on Hawaii, I live in my corner, my part of it, but she just took us, and I felt transported to every corner of these islands and all the different vibrations, the different nature elements that were coming through that practice. So thank you. I felt like I traveled within all the islands just in those few minutes. I want to share with you, Dr. Rulin shared very briefly what Malia is going to share with us on Saturday. She left, I heard a message from her this morning. And when she told me what she was going to share on Saturday, I was like, wow. I was already looking forward to this workshop, but this is something I am eagerly, eagerly looking forward to. I don't, like Rulin, I don't want to give too much away, but basically what she's sharing with us is like the Tao of Hawaii. And that's for Sunday, for Saturday. And it's going to be profound. And then while Rulin was teaching, I realized I had another message from Leah. I hadn't heard it before. So I took a few minutes away from your teaching to hear her message. And I want to share with everybody, Malia's not here today because she's traveling to the Big Island. And on the Big Island, she is really trying to connect to like, what can I bring from this island? Because Big Island is where it's the most dynamic right now. That's where Rulin lived. And that's where you feel the most deepest connection to that creation power of Hawaii. So Malia is really like trying to connect and gather, what can I bring on Sunday? And she's going to share a very special experience with us on Sunday that I'll probably be sleeping when the sunrise comes over the mountain in Big Island. But she's going to try and bring that really elemental energy to us. And she's going to record it for us so that we don't have to get up at 6 a.m. just to catch that, along with many, many other things. But what she just shared about the vibration of Hawaii, the real connection to it, to the raw energy here that we're going to experience through her on Sunday is something to look forward to. So I'm more and more excited about both the days. In addition to what Rulin just shared about, you know, she's got her experience living in Hawaii, but she's got the aha moment, the deep wisdom of how it all works through the Tao science. And I cannot wait, because this combination has never happened before. And so tomorrow morning, we will have another intro session, 9 to 10 a.m. Hawaii time. So if you have friends on the East Coast in Europe, you know, get them to that intro. 9 a.m. in Hawaii is 9 p.m. in Germany. And it's like 3 p.m. On the East Coast, but it will be recorded for those who are working at that time. Tomorrow's intro, Malia and Rulin will be with us together. So again, very, very powerful, looking forward to that. And then the weekend coming up. So thank you so much, dear Rulin. Thank you for this past hour. And thank you for all your experience that you're going to be bringing to us. And I'm thanking Malia on the soul level, because she will be with us too.
Thank you so much, Hardeep and Yanan and everyone here. So looking forward to connect with you, spend 2 beautiful days together. Yes, so much to look forward to. Thank you.
We'll bid everyone the warmest aloha, and we'll see you tomorrow and on the weekend. Bye-bye.
Mahalo.
Mahalo.